Welcome to everything you need to know to get started with Codux in 3 minutes. Let's jump in. Let's take a look at how we can select and preview components within Codux. So to preview my component, I can simply move over to preview mode. And now all the interactivity and functionality of the component becomes available. But the real Codux magic actually happens in select mode. Now I'm able to start selecting components. And by pressing this pencil icon, I can drill in and select the inner scope of this component. I can achieve the same thing by pressing right-click and selecting Edit Component. Now I can move around and select whatever inner node I want, for example, this text one, and to edit it, to say Learn More. Hit Enter, and the change was made. You can also notice that the scope I'm looking at is reflected in the breadcrumbs up here. Next, let's see how we can start applying some styles. I'll begin by opening up the Styles panel on the right side here, and selecting our button component on stage. The first thing we can see is here at the top our class's input, and this shows us what classes are currently being applied, as well as offer us the option to add new ones. Beneath that is the selector's input, allowing us to select which selector we want to edit and to change the styles for. And beneath that, a wide assortment of visual controllers. For example, let's say that we want to change the background color here from one variable to another one. And just like that, the style has been applied. Now, let's take a look at how we can edit the properties for our component. So once more, on the right side, I'll switch over to the Properties panel. And here we can see all of the properties, the settings, the behaviors for our component, and we can easily change them. So for example, changing this component from a small one to a larger one. I can also drill out to see another example and select our image, and this time Codux would offer the image picker controller, and here I can select any asset from my project or any other URL. To add new content to our existing component, we'll open up the Add panel on the left side here, and this will offer us all of the various native HTML elements, as well as all of the components within my projects that were automatically detected, as well as any third-party libraries that I happen to be using. Let's take a look at an example. Let's say I want to add an H3 heading. So I'll simply select that and drag that onto the stage. I'll grab a bit of the text here to move over into that subtitle and make sure that we have that edited. And just like that, our content has been updated. Because at the end of the day, Codux edits React, TypeScript, and CSS code, we always have access to the underlying implementation. And so if I'll select this button that we saw earlier and move back to the style panel, then I can simply go back to any of these controllers and select View Code. And now that brings me right to the exact line and location where my change was made. And so, all that's left is to take our changes, bundle them up together, and commit them back to our project. To do so, I will click this commit button at the top and add an informative message, such as edited button and added subtitle, and press commit. Now, all that's left is to simply press sync to push our changes back to the repository. I hope this was beneficial in getting you up and running with Codux. If you want to learn more, check out codux.com for more playgrounds, demos, and tutorials. See you next time.